On the unspoiled east coast of the far north, locally we're debating how best to engage with powerful foreigners, offering them a deal in exchange for the right to use the land as they see fit. The difficulty inherent in trying to understand how that will play out. It's hard not to hear an echo of Waitangi.
We still hold on to the values that were there in 1840.
Margaret Mutu is Professor of Māori Studies at Auckland University and the Chair of Ngāti Kahu's Runanga.
And have hopefully learnt a bit more about how to deal with immigrants, having had some pretty bitter experiences over the past 170 years. So we're hoping that we get it right, but we know we won't get it all right.
Professor Mutu says working with Shanghai Cred is simply pragmatic.
It's going to come whether we like it or not. Let's make sure that what does come doesn't end up destroying who we are and those very precious territory that's been handed down to us through the centuries. So just very painfully aware of the need to proceed so carefully.
Still, not everyone's convinced.
Those few Maoris that are saying, yeah, it's really good for us, need to look at a bigger picture. We're looking at not my generation, not my grandchildren, but five generations down from us. What are we going to leave them?
What are you most worried about changing?
Yeah, where do we start?
Back in Whatawhiwhi, Shanghai Cred told us via email that they were waiting on resource consent before answering questions, but that their relationship with Ngāti Kahu has been positive, with mutual respect and understanding for cultural values and tradition. Still, there's a feeling of worlds colliding.
How much money do you need? You know, that's enough. I think that's more than enough.
One of Katerina's neighbours has put up homemade signs on her fence, protesting the proposed development, saying things like mana, not millions. One or two have been modified, but you can still see the writing underneath. No invasion was originally no Asian invasion.
When she talked about those things, she said, you know, you have to be really careful how you put it out there. And that was Asian invasion thing, but you need to whip that off because that's Maori's been an asshole.
Margaret Mutu says while she remains cautious, her academic research into Chinese Māori relations and many shared cultural values make for optimism.
If you open up the door for the relationship in the right way and you're open and very clear about what your conditions are, then in my experience, the Chinese will always be respectful of that. And they're also very upfront themselves.
Ngāti Kahu cultivates that relationship.
Each year we take a cultural delegation up to Shanghai to meet with them on their own grounds and to understand the way they think. And of course what we see up there just blows us away because it is so totally different from Karikari Peninsula. But the reality is that you are dealing with people. And that very strong cultural requirement of the Māori world that the most important thing in the world is people. And people must get on with people.
Anahira Herbert-Graves believes language will be key to opening up understanding.
I'm thanking my mokopuna, learn Mandarin. I'm learning Mandarin. Learn Mandarin. You fellas, learn Māori.